ধন্যবাদ টেলিগ্রাফ। আজির দিনটো ডক্টর ভূপেন হাজরিকার জন্মদিন অ্যান্ড আই ফিল প্রাউড টু বি হিয়ার ইন দিস অকেশন অ্যান্ড ইন দিস ডে স্পিকিং ইন ফ্রন্ট অফ ইউ। অ্যাকচুয়ালি দিস ইজ মাই সেকেন্ড ভিজিট টু দ্য টেলিগ্রাফ NICT। I come here not to say something generally, I come here to learn something. I learned many things. Last time I met Vikas, I learned from him. I met entrepreneurs, I met people from the finance, from the industry. Well, the days are very hard for any entrepreneurs. Gayatri knows, she has contributed a lot as a woman entrepreneur, because he's still doing a lot for it. I'll tell you one small thing about me starting as an entrepreneur, or people call me entrepreneur because I'm into education and business for the last 24 years. If you talk about 20, 30 years back in Assam, if you say that what the guy is doing, if you say that he's doing business, or maybe he's having a shop, you'll not get good bride. How goina power kar hai? Ahomat, hoy doctor, choice, engineer, second maybe you know a government job. Today the scenario has changed. Assam entrepreneurs are being recognized. And any work is not taken as a small work. If you start with a lakh of rupees, like me, when I started CEC, I started with two computers with my father's retirement money, which he has kept it for my sister's marriage. And he asked me that whether you are going to be successful in doing computer business, because many people have started and my father has never seen a computer. He has seen a computer up from outside because he was a lower-level employee in Guwahati refinery. I said, Dutta, I want to start computer business. I am going to teach as a tuition house. Then he understood. Tuition means he is going to teach. Okay, fine. So that money has transformed me, or that particular day I still remember has been the turning point in my life. I still remember. That's why I say to my students also nowadays, whenever I meet anyone, parents cannot go wrong. They sometimes don't understand what you are exactly going to do. We have to make them understand. Now, as Mr. Gupta has said, when I was seeing the screen, so many opportunities are coming. You don't need to wait for your father's money or your uncle's money to do something. You need innovation, you need the use of proper technology in the right way. If you have that curiosity to go forward and do something in life, you'll get the resources. You'll get the right person. I'm sure about it, because when I started, it was individual. Now I'm lucky enough to have around 1100 members working under this group CEC, and around, as Tina said, as a teacher, as an entrepreneur, as 175 centers. I got lucky people around me in the entire Assam and Northeast to do a good show of an entrepreneur of what I can do. But I have not been groomed properly. I have not been done a proper homework properly, or maybe I was not grown up in that situation. 30 years down the line, if my son, who is now into, he's doing his university courses in Manipal, if he want to do something, he will learn from me, because from the childhood itself, he has been seeing me doing business and talking about business, or talking about how to save money or how to invest, what is the loss, what is the profit. For us, it was difficult. When I was in Delhi, I was supposed to say by one of the person in the Northeast fest, that Dipankar, you go and speak to a few investors who wants to come to Guwahati and in Assam and invest. Then I said only one word. Maybe I was speaking to them as not a speaker, like just interacting with them. Today you come to notice, the mentality of youth has changed. The youth doesn't need easy money. Now the youth or the students are looking for opportunities. If a good thing starts, they will come and work hard and they will earn money. Easy money is not at all encouraged or not at all been appreciated by the youth of Assam. I am sure about it. When I go to nooks and corners of Northeast as well as in Assam, I see the youth are coming up with maybe very small bit of innovations, computer institutes, training institutes, maybe some products, and they are curious to sell it, do business. Even the local resources, fishing and all, I don't have any idea about that. But I can see if they are making something at home, they want to sell it in the market in the proper way, in an organized manner. And they are not feeling ashamed of what they are doing. When my son was in class 9, I said one thing to him when he was coming out of his house and take your auto rickshaw. I said, I go with by the auto because there is no car or no driver. I have, but maybe he is not using that. Then I said, when you are going to auto rickshaw, the auto rickshaw driver is an entrepreneur. He owns the auto. You have to give him respect. You have to call him Dada Jabonigi, or means as brother, you have to say. If you give him respect, he'll say, okay, fine. Then you can say, all right, Pato, let's go. And he'll take you. But he'll not get the respect what he is doing. This is what today I'm happy the Telegraph has called us, especially me, to speak in front of you and giving respect and honor to an entrepreneur. If you do this, a small bit of person can also feel good what he is doing. The money which is to be invested by the bank can be utilized in a good way. He'll never feel ashamed of what he is doing. He'll be encouraged by 1 rupee. When you get 2 rupees by honor, he'll try to make it 3 rupees, and also he will pay back to the bank. He'll not think, hey, what is there? Nothing is there in life. I've started this, no respect, nothing. Even I'm not earning also good money. Okay, leave this business. Go back and do something else. That period is a very crucial period for a youth to restart him, reorganize, and start off something, maybe a new one. I always say the technology what has come today, we, the people of Northeast, cannot say that we are lagging behind, because if we were in Delhi, we might have done wonder. We might have studied in Bangalore, we might have done wonder. No, this excuse will not be there. I'll tell you, because when I meet any youth, they say, I'll not say the place name, but one person I met her and one person I met him also. Itya manu hobo aisho, gohati kotono kodim, master degree kodim, itya manu hobo. So Jotumi Asila, where you were studied from school to high secondary to college level, you will not be a goat or a cow. You have to respect your own place. You have to know what you are. If you have that, then you can do anything in life. I feel that. That's why if the technology has come up digitally, or maybe with anything, we should utilize that. We cannot say that, okay, fine, what is happening in America, we don't know right now. If any live thing is happening through television, we can see what is happening in America. That means what American boy is knowing the same knowledge, having the same knowledge sharing, and what we are getting it right in Guwahati and in Assam. How can you say that we are not getting that kind of maybe information? Only few things you may not get. There is the infrastructure, maybe, you know, that kind of appreciation, or maybe the bank. Today, as I was listening to Mr. Sanjeev Gupta, I was feeling good and I was discussing with Mr. Hajarika. Right. So much of money is coming to us, so much of things are coming to us. I used to say, when I was in 90s in Delhi, I had a Janmashtami celebration and I came home, and after that my mother said that Janmashtami is coming. I said, why? Because in 13th, you know, Assam is going to celebrate Janmashtami, and in India, Janmashtami is celebrated 15 days ahead. I said, ma, what about it? Any room Krishna Janma Var. I said, like the ma said, no, I'm going to beat you. I said that maybe, you know, we got a news late and we are celebrating today. It was not there, but whatever that part is different. But I am talking about today, what we can do. I have gone to US. So when we have gone there, it's not like I have money, I have gone there. I am trying to study there. What kind of hotels I can book, where I am going to stay. If I select this particular hotel, if I want to go to this place, whether it will be suitable for me, I have used the entire booking system of digitalization and I have gone to that place. But I say, if we do it in the correct way, the technology we use in the right way, we can save money also. To save money is also to earn money. I have seen, when I was in a subway, I was doing a train, though I had said, I have lost my way, which way I have to catch the train. The person used to take out this mobile, oh, you're going to the blue line, you have to go to the blue line, or you have to take this train from this line. He said, never said no. He has his technology in his hand. Now, our technology is in our mobile phones. We have to use that. We have to make the maximum utilization of the technology. I don't want to say much about it because I don't have any presentations. I want to only say that if the region grows, then I grow because I am in this region. If the people of Northeast become technologically utilized what is happening in there, and with proper time, they can utilize how we can do that. We are not going to be depending on anyone. One thing I used to say to my students in some maybe colleges, that, you know, if you ask someone, your friend, that what is this? Maybe the Mudra fund or Mudra,
maybe that bank
loan scheme. Oh, you don't know? Is Mudra is like this? The person feels shy. Lazara Diloyo. Oh, you should know everywhere it is. It is in the newspaper. Yesterday it came in television. And the person feels shy. Oh, okay, fine. Okay, this is how we go. There's only one friend which will not give you shy. Who will not say, oh, you don't know what is Mudra, what is the schemes, what is the SBI doing? You can ask that friend. That friend is a very crucial friend, which our student, I say, you should take that friend's help. That is the Google. The Google, if you write something, anything, the Google will give the information and never say, oh, you don't know this. The only friend who cannot give you shy, and you can ask and you can learn from that friend, and elaborately you can learn and you can utilize that. These kind of things are important in our life, and I think I was also from a particular medium school, but as Madam said, I have to say that the people of Northeast can speak English. Why? You know, we try to adopt what is there. But adoption and utilization should be parallel. We adopt it, but we don't utilize it. When we adopt it, we should utilize it. Like, for example, we have a fashion designing course. Recently, we are going to start the Mac lab. We will be starting that. We will be starting on 13th of this month. So a designer, fashion designer, it's not written your CV is a fashion designer. But the way civil speak, oh sir, you wear a black shirt, it doesn't look good. You should wear maybe a white shirt and a black tie or something else. or you should change your hairstyle a little bit, maybe, you know. Why are you saying this to me? Sir, I'm a fashion designer. I know you are a fat person. You look slim if you wear this kind of dress or a striped dress. If you wear a horizontal stripe, you look more fat. Oh, wow, how do you know this? I am, sir, I'm a designer. Like, if you see a patient, maybe a person is lying, two doctors will speak in their own language. Then you find out that both are in the medical background. So what is the lacking in SMS or the students now? They know they are not utilizing it. They should utilize it. By going to a BPO, I said one particular place, in the state of Assam, that if somebody asks you in English, oh, where is this SBI bank? They will start to hide them under the table. Oh, English of Kudisa, I should hide myself. I said, then you go to Thailand, you go to any Asian countries, or maybe in Russia, or maybe somewhere in European countries, who know France, if they ask, where is this bank, or maybe an SBI bank, they will not know English to speak. They will show this way, or this way, maybe with their fingers, because they have understood that. Why not we can do that? Start off with that. That is my startup. You should not hide yourself from under the table that English or Kudisa I am going to hide off. You should, if you have no that bank, SBI, okay, it's there in my head. Oh, this way. I just show. And the person will get that place. That's all. Same thing, when you do something, it's not like that we have to be mastered of it. Or as Mr. Dutta has said, that if you start something which other people have started, it's not like that. You have to know where your talent is. If your talent is good in something else, you should do that. You should not copy others. If you think I'm good in maybe in writing, I should write, and what you should write about your own place. Like in small, when you're small, people say, write a diary. Why? Because this writing habit can lead us to make us to a journalist. Small bit of thing in life we should pick up and we should utilize it. As my directors, they used to run the centers, I first tell them, you should not be a complicated literate, or all the subjects you should know, and now you can go and teach everyone. You can appoint a faculty member, you can appoint a receptionist or a counselor who will give the guidance, and they will do. Now what are you going to do? You are going to sleep at home, or as a director you are going to ride a bike or maybe a car and say, I am the director of CEC. No. You don't know computers? Okay, fine. You cannot do counseling? Okay, fine. You cannot sweep because you feel ashamed. If I clean the house and the cleaner, I am saving money. You cannot do that? Okay, fine. What you have? The time. You sit in the institute and see how the things are operating. Then the system will run properly. If you can utilize that time, you sit there as an owner, as a director, the faculty will teach properly, the students will come on time, the counselor will do the job properly. That means what? I should identify what I have. I should not identify, no, tomorrow I am going to learn from this faculty member, I kick him out because he is taking a lot of money, and I am going to teach. Oh, I don't need the counselor. I am going to sit there and do the counseling, and I am doing a good business. This is not right. You are utilizing those people and you are utilizing your own time and you are managing yourself. This is how it goes. Now CEC is not a single person's organization. Direct employees, we got 150. In our school, we got maybe 50 plus lady teachers. They say, sir, tuition Korea soon. Like we used to do teachers at home. I say, how, what it take? Like sometimes they give fees or something. But I say that no, you should organize yourself. Have you taken tuition for maybe 3-4 years? Now you go back, maybe you start it in a very organized way. 2-3 maybe students you can take from mine, take the money, utilize your time. Otherwise the lady used to come and say, up to 9 o'clock I used to do tuition, morning again I get tired, it's very difficult, I don't get, come on time to the school. Why are you doing till 9 o'clock? Because you are taking one individual student and taking 500 each, 1500 rupees. Go and go back, take some rest, get a rest, call them in your home together and teach them in 1 hour. This is the time management we should know. Assam is now the place now of land of Lahelai. Assam is going in a big speed and the time we should utilize in a very proper manner. If you can utilize the time in a very proper manner, everyone can become a good successful person. I am not saying successful in the bank balance. I am not saying the successful as recognition or something, maybe you know, owning a big car. Successful in the sense of every work. Even if you get an employee, I'll be happy if the employee is very sincere. She or he comes on time and give her 100% to my organization. I should get that. Even if you are doing a business, then you should get that kind of customers. If you open it at 8 o'clock your shop, maybe ice cream parlor, maybe a grocery shop, 8 o'clock has to be the time. Oh, people used to come at 9 o'clock. 8 o'clock I have started for 1 month. Now tomorrow I am going to open the shop at 9 o'clock. It should not be there. You have to make your own principles. And I think this is what I like to say in my experiences. And still I have 2 persons to learn. And I think I'm on time. It's 15 minutes. Okay. I have not exceeded the time also. Thank you very much. And thank you for listening to me. I wish this kind of programs will be very important for us and we can do a good, maybe you know, with the telegraphy. Again, I will thank them. Soumitro, I know him for a long time and the new team who have been following me. And Tina always, since today's restaurants, she's been hosting. Thank you very much.